I'm going to show you how to create an image carousel that looks like this. You can see that the images move from left to right, and when it reaches the last images, it'll go back to the first. So it looks really complex, but to be honest, it's really, really simple. Okay, without further ado, let me show you how to achieve this step by step. Let's create a frame and select iPhone 16. Next, select text, create a text. I've set it to 48px. I'm going to call it A. Right click, I'm going to do a add auto layout. For this frame, I'm going to change the width to 300 and the height to 300. Okay, once done, let me select the text and let me change it from fill to hard content. Select this frame. I'm going to give it a background color, maybe green, like this. And for the text, I'm going to change it to white color. Okay, for this, I'm going to call it item 1 or maybe image 1. Okay, let me just drag it below first to just give an illustration of how it's going to work. I'm going to click on image 1, copy it and paste it. Now we have image 2. For image 2, I'm going to change the color to some, just make it look a little bit different so that it's a little bit clearer. And instead of A, I'm going to change it to B. Copy image 2 and paste it. Now we have image 3. Change it to C. And I'm going to create a few more like this. Okay, so now I have 7 images. But for each of them, I'm going to give them distinctively a different color so that we can see how the image carousel is going to look like. All right, let me go to image 3 and change the color a bit darker. Image 4, I'm going to maybe change to a little different color like this. Going to call it D. For image 5, let me change the color to slightly darker blue. I'm going to change it and call it E. Image 6, I'm going to call it F. Okay, let me just change it to dark purple. And image 7, I'm going to call it G. For the background, it's going to be maroon. Okay, so these are my colors. What I'm going to do is I'm going to select all the images. Okay, in my case, it's honestly just a square, but you can replace it with images. Select all the 7 images, right click and add auto layout. Okay, for the frame, I'm going to rename it and call it image row. Okay, the next thing that I want to do is to select the image row and drag it into your iPhone 16 frame. Okay, you can place it somewhere in the middle like this for the first image. Okay, just roughly centralize it like this. All right, so now we have iPhone 16 1. Copy it and paste it. Okay, now for iPhone 16 2, I want you to select the image row within iPhone 16 2 and press shift, use your left click and drag it. Oops, let me just back a bit. Okay, within iPhone 16 2, click on image row, press shift, and I want you to drag this to the left like this, such that image 2, which is B, comes into view like this. Okay, now I'm going to copy iPhone 16 2, copy it and create a duplicate like this. I'm going to use the same technique, select the image row within the third iPhone and drag it to the left again like this. Okay, remember when you are clicking this and moving it to the left, you can press shift so that it doesn't move up and down. Okay, I'm going to do the same. I'm going to click on the third iPhone, copy and paste it. Now this is the fourth iPhone. I'm going to click on the image row. Okay, click on the image row in the fourth iPhone, press shift and click and drag it to the left like this. Okay, you notice that I'm just repeating the patterns. I can just click on fourth iPhone, copy and paste it. Now I have the fifth iPhone. Select the image row. I've selected the image row within the fifth iPhone. Press shift and move it to the left like this. I'm going to do the same for iPhone 5. Copy and paste it. Now I have iPhone 6. Select the image row in iPhone 6 and move it to the left like this. And of course, click on the sixth iPhone and paste it. For the image row in the seventh iPhone, press shift and move it to the left. Okay, I know I sound very repetitive, But I just want to emphasize that I'm just repeating the steps over here, okay? So now that I have duplicated the iPhone 16 times, and for each of these iPhone, you notice that the frame is different. For iPhone, the first iPhone is A, second is B, third is C, and so on, and the last one is G. Okay, so now that we have this seventh iPhone frames, what I'd like to do is to select the first iPhone, click on prototype. Let me zoom in a little bit. Okay, make sure you're selecting the iPhone frame. I want you to click on this plus sign to create a prototype and link it to the second iPhone. Okay, make sure you linked it to the second iPhone. For the trigger, you would like to select after delay. All right. For after delay, you can change the delay value if you want, but I'm just going to keep it as it is. For the action, I will set it as navigate to iPhone 16-2. And animation, you're going to change it to smart animate. For the curve, I'd like to use ease out. For the duration, I'm going to keep it as 300 milliseconds. Okay. Now I'm going to click on iPhone, the second iPhone. Click on the second iPhone. You can click on this plus sign and drag it and connect it to the third iPhone. Okay, for the trigger, same thing. I'd like you to change it to after delay. And then make sure that the delay amount, I'm just going to keep it as it is. The important thing is for the action, make sure it's still set as navigate to. For the animation, you got to keep it as smart animate and so on. All right, I'm just going to be repeating this action again. Click on the third iPhone, select the plus sign, and connect it to the fourth iPhone. Same thing for the trigger, change it to after delay, navigate to the fourth iPhone, and the animation is smart animate. Okay. Click on the fourth iPhone, do the same thing. Click the plus sign, connect it to the fifth iPhone, change it to after delay, and make sure it's smart animate. Okay. Okay, I'm just gonna finish it for the rest of the frame. For the fifth iPhone, connect it to iPhone, the sixth iPhone. Trigger is going to be after delay, 800, animation is smart animate. Click on the 6th iPhone, click the plus sign, and connect it to the 7th iPhone. For the trigger, I'm going to change it to after delay. Okay, make sure it's smart animate, and of course action is navigate to. Now for the last crucial piece, the 7th iPhone, click on it. Okay, zoom out a little bit until you can see the first iPhone. From the 7th iPhone, click the plus sign and connect it to the first iPhone. Same thing for the trigger, you change it to after delay, action is navigate to, animation, make sure you set it to smart animate. Alright, once you're done, what you can do is, let me just remove this, you can select the first iPhone, you can click on flow starting point, and then let me just call this demo. And then you can click on this plus sign to go to the presentation mode, and you can see that the image carousel, it's moving really nicely. From the last one, it goes to the first one. Okay, let me just show you in the presentation view so it's much easier to see. I believe you can see it now. It's moving from left to right automatically, and when it reaches the last image, it will move back to the first image. Okay, so of course right now I'm just using shapes. If you like to change the shape to an image, you know, it works the same way. So I hope that you find this video useful in creating this image carousel on Figma. You know, give this video a thumbs up so that I know that this video is really helping people out there. Also, subscribe to my channel. So I guess I'll see you in the next video.